Hi everyone, welcome to Healing Souls, dear friends. So dear friends, back again with a lot of excitement always for the upcoming 7 to 10 days reading. So this reading is always extremely exciting for me. As I always tell you that I love to do readings for collective. When I do a reading for collective, I obviously know it, I am a part of collective. So whenever I do a reading for everybody, I'm also very happy when the messages start to relate towards me also in the week. So of course, when I'm doing the reading, I'm never aware, and sometimes I feel that how this kind of a reading will apply to me. But even last week, the reading was so complicated. There was so much going on. And the last week's reading, and everything turned out to be applicable for me also. That was beautiful. And today also, dear friends, I have connected with all of my friends today. And now this, you know, there is more and more guidance that is coming for this weekly, every, you know, that reading that I'm doing. So this time, and always it could be applicable for someone of any of my friends also, that normally, whenever I'm taking my bath, that is the time I get the ideas. So I was taking my bath, wherein I got the idea that for this week's reading, before the reading, in the healing, we have to call Kali Mata. So I am calling Kali Mata and Archangel Michael, as and how they guided me to connect with all of my friends on Healing Souls, and they did tell me to use my scissors. So I am pulling the cords of the fear-based energy that I have sensed in the collective. This is a kind of emotional fear-based energy that I am sensing. As in that, you know, what I'm sensing even in the last week, that so much of positive was going on. So much positive, so many manifestations, emotional joy, everything was happening, yet the collective was very, very fearful. There was so much emotional, overwhelming kind of an energy that there is a fear that, you know, is it all going to remain just the way it is? So, Kali Mata and Archangel Michael gave me this guidance as I was taking my bath, that before the start of this week's energy, before I read for you guys, I need to clear you guys all of any emotional baggage, any fearful energy, any cords of fear attached with any person, place, situation from past of this life, past of any other life, or through any time or space, be release, be release, be release. Thank you so much, Kali Mata, Archangel Michael, for helping all of my friends release the emotional fear-based energy that, you know, brings down their bodily energy also, makes them feel heavy. All of it has been now release from your body, dear friends. And when I'm making this healing today, it is 5th of May, beautiful day of the 5-5 portal. So this could be your final 5-5 portal healing also. I made a lot many 5-5 portal healings. And this is the change that we are bringing with this healing, is that lavender, dear friends, for your third eye chakra, your mind relaxation, we are releasing the heavy burdens, emotional burdens, the fearful energy, finally, with this 5-5 portal. And I believe we are calling in the 5D consciousness. That's what I want to call in. You know, elevating ourselves, all of us, from the 3D, the third dimensional fear-based energies, towards the fifth dimensional energies, where there is faith, unending faith. There is no doubt, there is belief, and there is infinite abundance. Wow, what energy is coming our way. So basically, I just believe that with this 5-5 portal, you're going to enter into the 5D consciousness of the infinite abundance. Along with that, in this beautiful week, we are going to have our new moon happening in the sign of Taurus. So new moon is always a time frame of new opportunities that are coming into our life. And since it is happening in the zodiac sign of Taurus, it just simply tells me that this is a week you're going to manifest new beginnings that are of stability and security. Taurus is our second house, dear friends, the house of what we value. Taurus talks about grounded energy. I consider it as the 4-4 portal energy connected with Mother Earth, Mother Gaia. So very grounded energies, stable, secured manifestation. So this week, I believe, with the 5-5 portal and the 7th of May, the new moon that is happening, is going to bring in one of your very, very best, I mean, you know, tangible manifestations. I believe, like, in any area of your life, it can be, you know, because the second house does talk about our own finances. So it can be with regard to your financial growth opportunity, new job, or some kind of a career that you're setting up, something that is of value to you. Now, anything can be of value, you know, you putting value in yourself, you starting some kind of education regime, or you starting some kind of a you could be you could be finding value in your relationships, might be a bond with a child, a parent, a partner, or, you know, purchase, second house is, you know, valuable commodities, like, you know, car, vehicles, home, sale purchase, anything that is tangible, childbirth, marriages being fixed. So, you know better, dear friends. And I am, you know, what I'm sensing with all of these portals opening and everything, there is something beautiful that is emerging in me. Thank you so much, Divine, that, you know, this is a card reading. And just see what they're doing to me. I haven't even picked even one card, and they have absolutely shown me the energies of the entire week. It's like a reading without even picking up the cards. Like, you know, so much of connection with the Divine, so much of guidance, and so much of trust and belief in what I'm saying. As if, you know, whatever I am saying, even without seeing the cards, I know that it is going to happen in this week. So that is the beauty of this week, might be for all of my friends, that, you know, in this week, because of the doubtful energy that we just released, because of the negativity that we just released, there is going to be a lot of trust and faith. Because you're going to actually be able to see your manifestations coming true in this week. Tangible things are going to happen for you. And that is the reason that your trust and faith in Divine is going to grow in this week. So, dear friends, I've also burnt this candle with the cloves over here and rock salt. So I ask from the Divine Kali Mata, deities of the universe, divine benevolent beings of love and light, that all negative energies, any hexes, any curses, any evil eye, we release from the energy of the client, the person who is watching this video, from that person, from their loved ones, from their home, their offices. You can give your own intentions too. I want the highest good for the person who is watching this video. This candle is going to burn away all of the negativities, dear friends. If you would, in this week, whenever you are feeling tired, whenever you want to come back to this healing, do come back to this Kali Mata cleansing healings, and all of the cords of negativities are going to be released from your body, mind and soul. So as I did tell you, dear friends, I like to do this weekly prediction very slow and with a lot of healing that I want to give. This is the dragon's bloodstone that I'm using. I was called for this one. Even the dragons are, you know, helping us in the year 2024, staying in our aura, giving a lot of confidence and courage. So protecting us from any doubtful, fearful energy. Now let's see, dear friends, let's, you know, some of you must be thinking that, you know, she's not even starting the readings. However, I'm telling you the truth, dear friends. Whatever messages are coming to me, they are from divine only. I know. So maybe my knowing abilities are growing even more, and I just absolutely love it. So let us see. Dearest God, Universe, Holy Spirits, Guardian Angels, Master Angels, Ascended Masters, Deities of the Universe, give your divine energies into these cards. Let me find the cards and guidance messages as the overall energy of the upcoming 7 to 10 days. And dear friends, this is a timeless reading, but if you happen to see it when I'm making it, it is 5th of May today. So it's going to be 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. We can take it from 5th until, you know, 12th. Next week, most probably all of next week, or including Saturday, Sunday, 7 to 10 days. So like 5th to 12th or 15th, most probably. This is going to be the overall energy of the week. Let's see what it is. And I tend to see over there, because always the messages are coming from the third eye, from the guidance comes from above. And that is the reason any tarot card reader, any healer tends to see there. You know, a lot of people feel that, you know, she's not confident, so she doesn't see into the camera. It's not that. My eyes automatically go there when the messages are coming from there. So very extremely active energy in this week, dear friends. Love it. We have the Nine of Pentacles at the base. This is absolutely, I would call it as the energy of a Taurian person. I would call it as the energy of a Virgo, Capricorn, grounded energy. You are already in this energy, already feeling extremely abundant. Oh my world, we have the Five of Pentacles in reverse. Loved it. So coming from the place of, you know, where you have absolutely released your scarcity into the place of abundance, this is the card of gratitude, Nine of Pentacles. So you're in the energy of gratitude, coming out of the lack, loss and scarcity, already in such a beautiful energies, dear friends. What more we could have asked for? So I see that you have been, you know, I mean, it's a similar energy that I'm telling you, that your manifestations are coming true and there is, you know, gratitude and thankfulness. In this week, there is a very, very extremely tiresome karmic cycle that you're going to finally complete. And what is happening is that, you know, in this week, if there was any kind of rigidity, any kind of struggles, any kind of tough energy that was there in your aura, body, mind, soul, chakras, because if it is inside of you, then only it is going to be there in the outside situations that you are facing in your life. So might be the situations for you were always very challenging. You were resilient. You have been, you know, courageous. You have not given up. You stand there, you fight for yourself. But the situations have always been, you know, very extremely challenging. And this was from your past life karma. What is happening in this week? Oh my world. We have the Eight of Wands and the Two of Wands. First of all of the wands cards are telling me that this is going to be a very active week for you. Can be very much related to work, definitely for somebody. But however, the energy is extremely fast moving, fast forward energy. You know, I don't read the cards as they are typically. What I'm sensing, I'm reading that this, I feel that extremely swift energy. All that was rigid, all that was stuck, all that was challenging is now like, you know, this is swayed away with these 5-5 portal energies or the new moon energies or whatever healings you took or whatever you have been doing. Your aura is, you know, emerging extremely strong. And what energy now you're coming in is the flow energy. Now look at these wands, like, you know, flowing kind of an energy. And we have the Two of Wands. The Two of Wands is telling me that, you know, there's going to be travel, there's going to be planning for travel. This is a week of either you guys are traveling in this week, or I believe that, you know, travel is being planned. There is a certain news with regard to movement to another city, state or a country that could be coming towards you. However, I mean, this week is extremely active week. However, I see that there is a lot of support around you, and you are feeling grounded, and you are feeling that, you know, I mean, right kind of communications are happening, and you are willing to move out of your comfort zone. So literally for some of you, it is possible that, you know, you are going out and doing a lot of walking, like, you know, for a health perspective also. I believe that, you know, this is going to be a week when you're going to connect with Mother Earth, Mother Gaia. You're going to be extremely active. Many of you can pursue a lot, you know, want to start an exercising regime. It's going to be easy. You're going to go for a walk, you're going to do your yoga, your meditations. Your throat chakra is massively healing. Communications are going to be beautiful in this week. You know, whatever you're going to be communicating is going to be understood very well. And I believe that, you know, because of your communicating abilities, there's a lot of expansion that is happening now. All right, and I believe that you are releasing all of your karmic burdens finally with this new moon energy. And a good news with regard to, definitely it can be with regard to travel or partnerships that are heading into your life. So communications are going to happen to and fro, a lot of communications and a lot of travel. And I believe that, you know, this is a week that of partnerships. Now this can be in any area of your life, your work partnerships, or, you know, spiritual partnerships, as we did see in the last week, or it can be you know, love relationships, growth happening in that case. So it is definitely time for you guys to pack up your bags, prepare yourself for traveling or an actual movement to another city, state or a country. However, I see extremely high energy coming towards you. It can be with the new moon or the healings that you're taking that. So I'm clearing your throat also in this healing, dear friends. Some kind of a clearing is taking place in your throat energy also. So the energy of Mercury is also going to be there. That is like all, you know, Mercury, when Mercury was in retrograde, there was a lot of problem in communications. There was a lot of problem in traveling. But now that Mercury has gone direct, it's going to boost your, you know, if you go for travel, it will be good for, you know, communications are going to be good. All right. Let's see. Yes. You were feeling, you feel something is lacking in your life, perhaps love, money or goals. I believe this energy, that of lack, is now in reverse. In the upcoming week, we see that, you know, changes in your life, and we have the moon energy over here. Exactly. So this new moon is going to be extremely important for all of my friends. Anything that you felt is lacking in your life, that is perhaps love, money or goals, is going to be released. Changes, I believe, 5-5 portal and the new moon portal. So I believe this is a guidance for me also, and we can, you know, during the new moon healing that I'm going to make for the new moon happening in Taurus, I can help you guys release what is lacking in your life in case of love, goals, career, and we can induce the energy of new moon to bring towards you, you know, whatever is your desire. We can do that, and that is going to happen. Beautiful. Let's see one card, one more card as the overall energy. And also, dear friends, do comment down below that, you know, last week there was a lot that was happening in the reading. There was a connection with a younger male also, and there was spiritual partnership also. There was some kind of healing going on. So did you actually experience all that? You know, it would be good for me to, no, I mean, it's always a boost if, you know, the next week we do get to know that, you know, okay, this happened, that happened. So we have love on the base. Already all of the month of May is like your heart chakra opening up, and so the love energy is there. We have forgiveness energy. So yes, forgiveness is, you know, unforgiveness is one emotion which if we don't forgive, we keep our heart blocked. So most probably I'm going to attach in the reading 2-3 healings that I have made for forgiveness. You can take it in this week. And what did I tell you guys? This is a week of manifestations. We have number 8 and manifestations. Yes, I did say that, you know, I'm not even seeing the cards, but I'm sensing that, you know, this new moon in Taurus is going to bring your manifestations exactly. With the barrel card, that you felt that something is lacking in your life, perhaps love, money and goals is going to be history now. With the new moon energy, this is a week of your massive manifestations. Congratulations, dear friends. We are already done with the overall energy, and there is so much that is coming for you. Beautiful. All right, let's see what's your personality in this week, dear friends. All right, dearest God, universe, Holy Spirits, what is going to be the personality of my friend who is watching this video? We have the Page of Wands on the bottom. So, you know, I believe that, you know, last week also you have been in that adventurous mode, or there has been a younger person around you who is evident, could be your child, a younger lover or a sibling, somebody, or there was traveling happening, or there is traveling on your mind. But however, the energy is fresh. It is, could be the energy of your inner child. Oh my world, I just love it. You have the Three of Pentacles. So what is going to be your personality in this week? Your personality is going to be that you want to work in collaborations. I did talk about partnerships. Yes, you want to work with the team of people, you know, at any level it can be. Even if it is with your family, you want to get together with them, plan out things. And this is practical planning, like, you know, family sitting together. If there could be discussions about heredity money, there could be, you know, investments that you guys want to make in your properties, or you want to do sale of purchase of your homes at a home level. It can be, you know, building up a family also, you coming together, planning a child, or it could be that, you know, the family is coming together, planning a marriage, that, you know, if you work, you know, in a relationship with somebody, you want to come in contact with the parents and you plan, you know, there is something that is building up, like in the personal relationships, it can be in family, anything that you guys are, and this is something tangible that you want to build together. With the new moon in Taurus, it is all possible, and there are going to be good, you know, relationships. You're going to be appreciated for your contribution in your family. And, you know, your ideas also. I did see that this week is very, very important with regard to people for their career and work also. So I believe that your personality, like, you know, people who are working this week is going to be extremely strong for your profession, career, business, work. There is a lot of teamwork happening, and there is a lot of appreciation that is coming towards you. And you are also appreciating your team members. You know, you could be a leader, you could be a subordinate person, or you could be in any post, but however, we always have people working above us or people working for us, with us. You are an inspiration for a lot many people, and you do admire them. You give your guidance, people seek your guidance simultaneously. You are also providing your affection, your attention, your appreciation to your people, you know. You are receiving it as well, you are giving it. So this could be a time in your work area also where, you know, there's a lot of partnership, you know, good conducive environment, collaborations. If you're doing your own work, you could be people who are working on YouTube channels, it is possible that you choose your team to collaborate with somebody and work with them. Similarly, in any platform, it is that, you know, you're choosing your people. And if in this week there is a certain employee that, you know, you're keeping as your subordinate or as a help, somebody is going to be really good who's going to come towards you. You could be getting offers of upgrade. So overall, I see that, you know, this is an energy of expansion in your work area, in your goal areas. And if you're a creative person, you're creating your art, doing anything in your profession, there's a lot of appreciation, affection and attention. You're highly thought of, dear guys, dear friends. You're highly thought of. So your team, you know, basically is loving you extremely. That is beautiful. Let's see what else is there. So, yeah. So I did say that the energy is a lot of communications, you know, to and fro. And I did say that your throat chakra, they're telling me heart is also healing. So the communications are conducive. Yes, we do have two kind of energies always coming in. Again, we have dissatisfaction with life similarly. So this is going to go away in this week because we have dog again. We have a far away. So dog again is the, you know, energy of somebody who is very loyal, and we have dog far away. A distant friend is thinking of you. So this person is loyal. This person brings into your life very healing energies. Now this could be literally your dog, that, you know, you have a spiritual connection with this dog. Now this dog can be in heaven also, or might be you have your own pet and there is a soul connection with this, you know, as a soul spirit. They protect you, they guide you. There's something, some connection with a pet of yours. Or this could be, you know, they say distant friend, a loyal friend who is staying in another city, state or a country, and you come in contact with them and they are, you know, uplifting you. They are always, you know, healing you. Something good, some kind of an opportunity you can get through them. Something of the sorts can happen. So a distant friend is thinking of you because and this is a week of travel also. So it is possible that you're traveling and meeting a friend or family member who is very loyal and you extremely love it. And it is also possible that in past you did have situations of dissatisfaction with this person only. But now with the moon energy, there are changes coming in your aura. Your energy body has changed and so their outlook has also changed. So might be somebody who was extremely, you know, jealous of you or fearful of your energies is now changing and is more appreciative of what you're doing in your life and, you know, how you are manifesting your own things, and they look up to you. Something of the sort I'm sensing. Let's see, dear friends, what else? So we are checking your personality. All right, so for your personality, let me check a card from here. All right, let's see. Any guidance for the personality of my friend in this week? Beautiful, you know, collaborations. There is no competition that you're sensing, actually. There is cooperation. That is your motive in this week, and we have being in the flow, exactly what I was saying. And just look at the beautiful card, dear friends, exactly what I said with the Eight of Rods energy and the Two of Rods energy, that now you're in the flow. All the rigidity is not there and the things have started moving. And we have the new moon energy in this card. If you can see, we have the new moon energy, we have the water energy, that the water, see, emotions have not now started flowing easily. And the card says, I am in the flow of the universe. Exactly what I was sensing, that this is the week that, you know, all of those challenges, those struggles, that rigidity from inside of your body is going to end, and that is how you go with the flow, and that is how you attract your soul tribe. And more than that, not just your soul tribe, people who were not aligned with you before or who could not see you as who you were have also started noticing that, you know, there's something very real about this person. There's something very authentic. Yes, they do have those talents. It's not that they're not faking it. They're not faking it. They're not making it. There is something inside this person for sure. And that is what they're going to notice. And that from there, your appreciation, affection, attention is also coming. However, to tell you the truth, dear friends, you don't care. You don't care. Now you're just so much in love with yourself, your life and whatever you're doing that, you know, you hardly care what anyone thinks of you. And now with this change perspective that, you know, you are totally, totally loving it, what you're doing. People have started, you know, sensing something different in you. And that is beautiful. Now let's see what's there in your environment. So your energies are going to be grounded. What I'm sensing is that, you know, even when you're coming in contact with so many people, your energy is different. You are not attracting their energy. You are in your frame of energy. That is beautiful. So let's see what's there in your environment. Environment as in, you know, there could be people, challenges, opportunities. Let's see. All right. We have beautiful things happening in your environment. Love it, love it, love it. So we have the star card. So massive healing has occurred in the last week with the star card, you know. And this is emotional with the water over here. There has been hope. There has been inspiration. Might be a certain wish came true for you last week, or it is coming true. However, oh my world, the energies for you in the environment. We have the Two of Cups. We have the leader card, I call it, the King of Wands, and we have the Five of Swords in reverse. You know, I consider these, both these cards, the Five of Swords upright and the Two of Cups upright, as the opposites. The Five of Cups card, Five of Swords card upright, I call it the card of an egoistic person. And the Two of Cups card, I call it as the card of a person who operates from love and compassion. So this card is coming in reverse. That is absolutely beautiful. So exactly what I was sensing was that all of those people, it could be with the 5-5 portal healing, the one I made where I did say that no one is going to be able to use you now. Oh my world. I call this as a card of narcissistic people. So all of those toxic people, narcissistic people, they are getting out of your life, or most probably, you know, I don't know what happened in your energy or anything. They are not being able to use you. But however, their toxicity also you have been able to heal somehow. Even if you are in contact with these people, they'll see something different in you, and they will understand in this week that, you know, no, this is not the person. I'd rather take lessons from this person than give them, you know, tough time. So that karmic cycle, that complete karmic cycle wherein you were the victim and they were powerful, there is dynamic change. We have the King of Wands, and you become the leader. What a power dynamic change, dear friends. So we have these people, the same people who were jealous of you, who were narcissistic, who were toxic, now seem to see the leadership qualities in you. And there is also possibility. The choice is yours. There's possibility that they give you offers of partnership. They send appreciation, affection and attention towards you, and they tell you that you guys are leaders. So this is something really strange, but if it does happen with you guys, do let me know. I have goosebumps as if the universe is saying yes, yes, yes. That, you know, people who tried to use you, and, you know, I mean, forgiveness, we got that card. It is possible that they ask for forgiveness. This is unbelievable. Might be you had not forgiven them for their acts for the tough time that you guys went with, but in your environment is a total alignment coming. I mean, anybody to everybody wants to come towards you. Anybody to everybody believes that you are the leader, and they are like, now they are like, no games, no bad games with you, please, no bad games with you. You are very strong. Like, you have Kali Mata. Oh my God, bless me, bless me, bless me. Can you imagine that kind of, you know, I'm sensing that it's that kind of a situation. Even if they don't say, it is like something that they want to be your friends. Now they are like, you know, oh my God, this person is powerful. Unbelievable, unbelievable. So what is there in your environment? I would exactly say is a very conducive environment. There is mutual give and take of love and compassion, which you've always craved. You always kept giving, but there was nothing coming in return. But this week is going to be amazing when you will see that something changed in your energy, and there are leadership opportunities for you. Upgrades, leadership opportunities. People see a lot in you, and you know, they want to come together and give you the best of the best offers. We are going to have a dealing with a fair man and a younger woman also in this week. So we have a younger woman. Dealing or relationship with a younger woman is going to be significant. So the people who are going to be important for you in this week is a younger woman. Now you know better how this younger woman is, you know, related to you. Now this could be somebody who was, you know, jealous of you, or you know, who could not understand you from the place you used to come from. This can be somebody's daughter, somebody's daughter-in-law. This can be your friend. This can be, I mean, your lover, anybody, but a younger woman. And this person is going to be evident for you in the upcoming week. And then we have the fair man. So this man can literally be fairer in complexion than you, or this person can be fair in their dealings, or this person, as they say, dealing or relationship with a man with blonde, gray or white hair. So, or they can have blonde, gray or white hair. They they can be older in age. They can be your father, your father-in-law, somebody, you know, who is older or maturer than you. Can be your partner also. Can be somebody in your office place, or they can have blonde hair. This could be a person of another city, state or a country you're going to deal with. So these two people are going to be evident in your environment. Okay, what else? Oh my God, we have a dark woman also. So there are three people we are seeing in your environment. We have a fair man, we have a younger woman, and we have a dark woman. So a lot of dealing. I did say that, you know, a lot of communication, a lot of people around you. But I believe that, you know, even if they were toxic, even if they were narcissistic, even if they were not appreciative of you, they see something in you and they are all like, oh my world. We stand for you. We root for you. We are for you. So, dealing or relationship with a woman with dark complexion or hair. So, this woman is slightly darker in complexion than you. Or might be she colors her hair very dark. Or she has very dark hair like black or jet brown. Or her complexion is slightly dark. So, these are the people who are going to be in your environment. So, I mean, I'd love to hear from you, dear friends, that, you know, who were these people. Sometimes, you know, this card which shows up, darker woman, turns out to be Kali Mata for me. And thank you, Kali Mata, if you are there, because, you know, Kali Mata is Kali, is dark in complexion. So sometimes I have seen that I get these cards that, you know, dealing a relationship with a person dark complexion, it turns out to be Kali Mata protecting me throughout the week. So I believe that in this week, if we take Kali Mata healing, it's going to be really good that she's going to be by our side. So what else is left for us? The final guidance. However, the whole reading was a guidance. I loved it absolutely. But I'll pick these cards to see the final guidance for us in this week. Beautifully blessed week, dear friends. Coming together with people, family, friends. A lot is happening. A lot many people are going to be there. Loved it. We have understanding and we have the rainbow. So there is an energy that is changing in your body. You're becoming, see, you're doing your meditations, your yoga, your, I did say that, you know, you're going to be grounded. You're going to be doing your things very well. We have, again, we have the Two of Cups card with unity, and we have the Nine of Cups card, which says good fortune. Oh my world. So coming together, aligning with the energies of good fortune. That is the week for us. Nine of Cups is absolutely the card of a wish come true, good fortune and unity. That is collaborations, that is partnerships, people coming together. So with the union of the right people, or now even I believe that the ones who were wrong for you, something in your energy changed, that they are also, now they are believing that, you know, this person is the right person for me. So let me see which card we are going to read from both of these. Oh wow, we have the good fortune card that they want me to read. So let's see, dear friends, what's coming as the guidance, overall gist for this week. Wow, amazing, amazing, amazing. So a week of a big wish fulfillment, dear friends, and good fortune. That's going to be the title, a week of good fortune. We have abundance. Wow, oh my world. We have Nine of Cups, good fortune, abundance, rewards, appreciation, accomplishment. How they, you know, I mean, how do they do this? Yeah, they synchronize everything in just one card. Whatever I've been reading for so long, the final conclusion, they give it all in this card. The Nine of Cups is the Tarot's wish card. Okay, let's keep the card. Keep taking the energies, dear friends. And don't overdrink in this week, definitely. So many cups. It can signify anything from finding your dream job, partner or house to getting a promotion or winning an award. Oh my world, we were seeing it all through and through. Anything is possible right now in love, work or home life. If there's something you want, now's the time to go for it. From joining a dating site to submitting a book proposal. This is a card where your hopes and wishes really do come true, and the goals and the gods and goddesses answer your prayers. I believe Kali Mata is going to be extremely strong by our side. She's going to answer our prayers in this week. I believe goddess healing. Oh wow, we can take the goddess healing playlist for entire week. Wonderful. Goddess healing playlist, yes. Symbolizing a happy heart and grateful spirit, it can also predict joyful times with friends and loved ones and a new relationship for single ones. Absolutely love this, love this, love this energy, dear friends, and make the most of this week. Enjoy, 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 celebrate, trust, have faith, grounding you in this energy, dear friends. Absolutely looking forward for the new moon energy and a healing that I'm going to make for the new moon, dear friends. Do look into the comment, into the description of this video for the healings that I'm going to put. Sending you lots of love and best wishes, dear friends. Now disconnecting from your energy. Love it, love it, love it to be with the collectives. Do comment down below, dear friends. I read all of your comments. And this month we do have a contest also, that, you know, anybody who's going to comment the most on the videos is going to get a chance. You know, on 25th of May, I'm going to check who is that lucky person who commented on all of my videos, or, you know, the one who has the maximum number of comments is going to get a free video, personal video for the entire prediction of the month of June, along with a healing like this. So comment down below. Lots of love and best wishes. Thank you very much, dear friends. Disconnecting from your energy. Enjoy your week thoroughly well. Thank you.